Guys, with two video, it basically I'm gonna talk about what I have been not why I haven't been recording much gaming videos, and this is Minecraft Dungeons. And if you read by the title, okay, this is a little bit off topic, but if you read by the title, I'll be shooting my best Minecraft Dungeons account. Is the camera sideways? If it is, I'll fix it afterwards. But let's get to this. So I have been playing this a lot, so it shouldn't be that hard. Adventure mode, and I've been trying to... I'll be showing off this in a different episode, and this... Okay, so we're actually going to the lower temple. So my armor is pretty good, so I'm gonna go to this one, which my power is one below, which is pretty sad. So it's a secret mission. I remember I tried this off camera, failed miserably. Yeah, the camera is sideways, okay. Okay, so yeah, let's get into this. Minecraft Dungeons is a fun game, which I recommend y'all playing too if you really need a game to play over this, like over the weekend. Or tell me something. Did I just hit myself my own bow? Okay, guys, it might look like I'm trash in this game, but I'm not trash, guys. I am not trash. That was my bow's fault. The bow hit that guy and came straight at me like, that was not fair. And if you might be wondering, there is another video coming out after this, a story time video, which I'll tell you in that video. But now I know if it's just a flick, do not shoot anything at it, unless it will kill you. So let's do this. I need emeralds. If you didn't know, I actually have over 5,000 emeralds. And you don't have the deflect feature, so I won't be getting arrows back at me. Of my overpowered bow, because that thing two-shotted me, even though I have like 1,000 health. You want some of this? You want some of this? Yeah, you want some of this. I'm trying to beat this. And if you guys actually want more of this game, which I actually have been thinking about making. Crap, this is dangerous. Run, 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 run. I really want to go back to this game now. Figuring out there's more stuff now, like new enchantments. My arrow, like the bee enchantment, that's new. Oh crap, who else wants some? You want some? Yeah, you want some. Yeah, yeah, no, 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 no. You stay back. Crap, he died. Yes. Come on. I'm gonna be showing him off after we die. I'll be showing this guy off. Actually, let's go back to return to camp so I can get. I don't think I should be going off topic, so I can just get to the point. I don't know this video. I already know this video is gonna be short, but I just want to get to the point about my best character on Minecraft Dungeons. So I have. So I have armor that has, it's called the Hunter's Armor, it's rare, and you might be thinking, it's from the Hunter's Armor sucks, not from the new levels in Adventure. In Adventure, the armor gets better. I have 961 health, plus a 20 extra, which is 181, and that's good. But plus, and then I get plus 10 arrows per bundle. So I'll get to my best, my crossbow soon, but my crossbow is insane. And let's get to the point about the armor. So the 30% plus rain damage. That's why you saw me getting hurt so much. It's because this armor is insane against people. If it hits someone, it hits you back super hard. So let's get to my sword, and we'll save the bow for last. My sword is 319 through 567 melee damage. That is a pretty good sword. It's called the Claymore. The Claymore is a pretty good sword if you have good enchantments on it. I have Prospector, because Prospector, I'm trying to get a lot of emeralds right now so I can buy a lot of those crates. And if I can buy crates, I can get better armor, which I need, because if I'm going to beat the game twice, which I will be trying to record me beating the game twice for you guys. But this sword is very heavy, which means it literally has a speed which is like close to zero, which makes it very bad. But the area is pretty big and the power is big. It's just the speed. So yeah, the sword is good if you have good enchantments on it. But you can get free enchantment levels on it. But mine only has one. So that's why I'm saying all that. And my, I forgot to say enchantments on my armor. The enchantments on my armor was Snowball, which makes it will snowball go around you, and whenever someone gets close, it blows snowball at them, which freezes them. But in Tumblebee, a new enchantment. Tumblebee spawns bees, which I feel like I shouldn't have got, because bees, I barely roll, because you have to roll to get the bees out. That's something that if you really like rolling in Minecraft Dungeons, then use the Tumblebee. So let's get to my crossbow. My crossbow is called the Heavy Crossbow. It actually does 552 range damage. And the Heavy Crossbow has something called Powerful Shots. And Powerful Shots are very good because like you can hit them like a big punch. And that is what a chance you want. Because you know, a crossbow has very slow speed. Like, very slow. So let's go to my chance on it. I have Few Shots. Few Shot is a little thing where if you shoot the arrow, you have a percentage of making it hit. So let's see how much I have it. Every third shot. That's every third shot, I will get it. And rapid fires make it so you shoot faster, which is very good if you're having the good stuff. So if you can see, my actual inventory has all of that junk in it. This is not junk. I actually like having these now, because if I need something for a regular level, then I can have it. The iron. Wait a second. Okay, never mind. I was getting distracted. So let's not talk about those, since those are for other videos. So let's actually get to my stuff. The lightning rod. The lightning rod is insane. It's insane, but you need souls for it. So souls are basically when you kill something, you'll get souls. Souls are very good for some elements. Like this, the lightning rod does 1,600 damage to an area. It summons lightning to a big circle, which I think is pretty good. It's kind of big, but still, the circle is pretty good. But it has 2 second cooldown. That's not really that hard. It matters how many souls you have. If you have a bunch, then that's gonna be pretty bad for you, and you're fighting against the last boss fight and everything. Yeah, pretty bad. And that's really it. But the lightning rods are very good. So let's get to the corrupted beacon. I love using this thing. The corrupted beacon was actually my friend traded it to me. And I was like, thank you, bro. My friend traded me the corrupted beacon, which is very good. But the corrupted beacon does 1,091 artifact damage per second. That is very good. And I really enjoy having this thing. So, and something else, the cooldown is 2.5 seconds. So if you stop doing it, it will do a cooldown. But if you keep doing it, it won't do a cooldown. But the souls, you need souls to do this. But it gets you one soul per kill, which is basically normal. So let's get to the next item now. The Totem of Regeneration. The Totem of Regeneration, it creates a small wool circle of regeneration for you. So let me show, I'm going to show off everything here just after this to show you all the good stuff about it. So the sort of like, it just like makes you an aura around you that would heal you, which is very good. And I feel like it's very, very like helpful to me, even though there's actually something called the love metal, which, never mind, I thought that, I'm getting distracted. I thought that was actually, never mind. No, it's soul healer. The soul healer will heal more, like, it'll heal you, but I have a pretty, it's same level with soul healer. And if you look at it, the soul, but this one, okay, so soul healer is actually pretty good, but you need souls. Like it says in its username, the soul healer you need souls for, which is pretty bad if you really want to get fast and you run out of souls because you have a whole inventory of souls. I have a whole inventory of mostly souls, but still, my last item is actually a ton of regeneration, which is pretty good. I recommend having a ton of regeneration just for safe measures. So, yeah, and the ton of regeneration, its cooldown is 25 seconds, so if you really, really are low, make sure not to use this without you being very low, because this will basically heal half your health. Very good. So let's show off some of this stuff. We're first going to show off my sword. Let's see how much damage this thing does to a dummy. 319, 390, and 567. That's pretty good. So let's see about the bow. So yeah, that was pretty good, but that's all I can really show. It matters how you're hitting it. If you're hitting it straight on, hard, like very, if you're slamming it, or if you're hitting it straight on, or if you're swiping it. Swiping is, hitting it straight on is the least amount of damage you'll get. So let's show how much damage there is for shooting it. 718, and see how fast, see 100, see that? I'm usually just getting few shot now, and it's doing 1,436. So yeah, it's good for that. But let's show off my armor. I don't know how I'm supposed to show this off, but I'm gonna jump off like this cliff right here and see how this goes. 210, because you know it levels out your, it levels out your health. But you see how that, look, that's barely any health, but still. That, you see how much health that is, like, that's a lot of health adding it all together. So we're gonna show off the little totem. The totem does this, basically. It's very good because you could just stand here and start shooting like that. And let's show off the lightning rod and the art of the card to begin. So the artifact, the lightning rod, you just saw it. It's very insane. I recommend having it. You just need it to be good. So, and then I'm going to show you this last thing and tell you my level and how you can get all this stuff easily. So, let's, I'm going to show you the Corrupted Beacon now. See how fast that's going? I think that's insane. But I usually use this against, the very hard people to kill. I use this against them. And then there, you see it ran out. It's regenerating it. Then I get all my souls back since I'm in the lobby. So let's show you guys my level right now is actually, I'm not gonna show you, but it's 60. I'm level 60 right now, 29 experience levels used. I usually don't use any of it. So you see, I'm not gonna go in the shop, but you can see I have a lot of levels and a lot of stuff. Now I'm gonna tell you an easy way to do this. You go. If you have beat the game once, there's a very easy way. You basically could just do this. You could just run over to the end, try it, and keep fighting those guys until you get high level. Higher, 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 higher. It's just easier to do. So I tried doing that like that. Or you do these little missions called the Underwalls or the Lower Temple. Like, some of them I don't have. Because I have a lot of these, but I don't have, like, this one. I don't have this one. Like, I know what these are, but I don't have them. But still, if you have those, you should be doing them. Because they get you a lot of XP. It's just something good to do. So, that's really it. It is. So, let's go back to lobby. And let me show you, let me tell you that. This is just tips. You don't have to do these. If you really feel like you don't have enough time to do any of these, there's an easy way of just trying. It's just doing it in your spare time, going on the game, going on a level, and starting to, like, fight people, and then leave the level after you get one XP, because you know you're not going to win. So, yeah. That's something. And always remember about your artifacts and everything on your armor. Because if you forget about that, it's just going to be bad for you, because then you're going to... You're gonna forget all about it. It's just gonna be bad. And then last level, you fail. Like, okay. Like, it's good. But the reason why I really don't wanna show me beating the game again, because I do this. Some people call it hack, some people don't call it hack. It's basically like you hiding behind this lamppost and then start fighting the last boss. That's what I do. It's an easy way. I feel like that was intentionally there because me and my friend tried to beat it so long and it was just impossible without doing that. So yeah, I feel like you guys should be doing that on the last level just to get an easy win. But whenever I'm recording it, I'm going to try to do it without that. And we're going to see. So yeah, that's it guys. Like, subscribe. If you guys really enjoyed me talking about this, then you guys should be doing that because it really helps out my channel and I really enjoy making videos for y'all. So if you guys enjoyed and really want to help me out, like and subscribe. It's an easy way, free, do all that. Now I'm going to stop advertising and just cough the camera.